evening, everybody. We begin our newscast with a look at the latest weather conditions.
Yeah, no amount of wishing could stop it. The snow started to fall last night, fell all night long into the morning hours. We do have team coverage tonight. We begin with 11 News reporter Kai Reed. She joins us live from Glen Burnie. And Kai, I hear they really got quite a bit of snow.
They did, Dan, and I want to start off talking about the roads. I just got the phone with county officials who tell us that they're about a little more than 80% done with the cleanup. About 200 trucks have been out on the road since last night when crews went out and started the pre-treating process. This has been a very big job for them, and just like most everyone else, they're ready for a nice long break.
Yeah, it's too cold out here. I went to summertime. It was 2 days ago. I was riding with the top down. Now I can't take all this snow. I want the summer to come.
The winter weariness has set in for the folks we ran into in Anne Arundel County, where nearly 10 inches of snow dropped in some places. The snowblower, shovel, salt, and all the work that comes with them have well worn out their welcome.
Oh, it's been a lot of work. It's been a lot of work with cleaning your car, and, you know, I live in an apartment, so... Cleaning the sidewalk, just getting out every day, trying to prepare for your day. It's been a heartache.
I took the snow blower out, had it a little bit, but once I got to the driveway, it was like slush underneath of it because it was warm, so the shovel came out.
Severn, Odenton, and Pasadena got the most snow in the county. And road crews were ready. After some concerns about running low on salt, public works officials secured another 8,000 tons before the storm. Crews started pre-treating roads at 10 o'clock Sunday night, and they'll rotate 12-hour shifts well into Tuesday morning.
So we hit the main roads, the arterials, as well as the bus routes. So that's why we think we fared pretty well on the main roads, because we pre-treated and the pavement temps were up a little bit, so that helped us out as well.
The snow forced delays and cancellations at BWI, where crews worked hard to clear off runways and de-ice planes. Airport officials reported 7.9 inches of snow there as of 8 a.m. On the roads, county officials are asking drivers to be patient, and they're hoping that this is the finale.
This is, I think, our lucky 13th storm, believe it or not, and that's all the little things that occurred, the sleeting and freezing rain, so they're worn out, quite frankly. It's been nonstop, and you know, they are looking for some needed rest here. In 4 days, spring occurs, so we're crossing our fingers.
I think that's true for everybody. So the side streets are the lowest priority. Those will be a big project for crews throughout the night. And at this point, everything is passable, but county officials warn that people should not expect all roads to be clear all the way down to the pavement until tomorrow afternoon. Reporting live in Glen Burnie, Kai Reed, WBAL-TV 11 News.
All right, thank you, Kai.